Interface is an exhibition of paintings exploring how artists with disabilities interface with the world around them, and will run for 2 weeks, starting this Saturday, 11th of February, at Lindenhall Studio. Displayed will be the work produced by artists who are members of local charity, ARC, an arts, health and wellbeing centre which supports people with physical disabilities and sensory impairments and is based on Tontine Street in Folkestone. Their work will be displayed alongside paintings by well-loved local artist and community activist Phyllis McDowell, who unfortunately passed away in January this year. When I enter an exhibition or a gallery, view the works on display, look at a creation in whatever form it has taken, there is always a question in the back of one's mind. How did this reach its final destination? On a wall or a plinth, ready for an unknown audience to come and view it? The creator slips into an invisible, obscure irrelevance. Yet over the course of the year, leading up to this show, I was fortunate enough to spend some time with the artists behind the names on the poster. My aim was to give an insight into the real people who have created this work, and hopefully allow you, its audience, a snapshot of their personality.
I think what we could do is, there's two ways, we could add coils, or we could add a piece of clay and work with the shape of it onto here.
Yeah.
Because you could work with that idea of a cave and have this part maybe just slightly covered over the wall of the cave maybe.
Yeah.
And then the pebbles are coming out of the cave.
Yeah.
Just a little... maybe it is like a little opening in the rock. More than a proper cave.
Yeah.
Just where the sea's made a hole in a rock.
So you have to keep it wet then?
Yeah. I've got a degree.
Oh, is it in art?
History of art design.
Oh, okay.
And film.
I did film.
Really?
Yeah. Where did you do yours?
Middlesex.
Have you ever been to Deal? Oh yeah, I think I might. I can't remember if I was there that day.
No.
No. It's a nice place.
Do you want me to help?
Definitely, yeah. But it's in February, so lots of time.
Put them up.
Yeah, maybe. It'll be in. We'll figure it all out close to the time, probably.
Buildings, hasn't
it?
Yeah.
Will it be on TV?
Yeah, I've been around that.
I don't know about that. Sorry, Sarah, I'm hogging all the clay. It is, it's nice, yeah.
Will it?
Yeah.
A ball, a little one.
A little one. Do you want it to roll it into a ball?
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm not very good at this. How's that? Is that too big?
All right, I think she used the ring.
What's that?
Roll out.
And straight down the middle.
Charles uses the paddle to flatten.
Doesn't that hurt?
On the right, yeah.
No. I like that. I like this one.
Yes.
So a bit of
both.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ah.
Yeah.
Someone else is behind it. I like the broken glass. That's nice. It's quite light. Once they've been fired.
Okay, then put some more beans.
Yeah. Thank you. It's a nice feeling.
Thank you. So, give you a ball, Charles. And this is great clay. So we just need it.
We just watch us out that.
And you could.
Sorry, I'm enjoying it too much. Sorry, I'm playing with your clay. When I was a kid, I used to do this all the time.
I did it at school.
Did you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't learn it at school. Did you make pots and stuff at school then?
Yeah.
Have you still got them? You should keep them. Whereabouts did you go to school?
In Surrey.
Oh, okay. Oh, did you move to Folkestone then?
We live in France.
In France?
Oh, okay.
It's lovely here in the summer. My best friend lives in Surrey.
Where?
Godall, Guildford?
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you been to Guildford?
Yeah. I love where I did. What? Given.
Oh, okay. So do you want this one?
It's
all right. What do you think?
Yeah.
It's me.
Just regular. Do you
It might be similar to
Yeah,
I think that's good. It's got a nice shape. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So are you doing 12 altogether? Sarah uses mixed media to explore the local coastline. Her work is highly tactile, and she is consistent in her use of colours. She works conscientiously to detail each piece, producing a body of work which reflects the beauty and experience of the world she sees before her. How long have you been coming?
About 3 years.
Oh, quite a long time.
Yeah.
Do you like it?
I love it.
That's great. I'm not sure yet. I'm just trying to get the feel. You've got a good feel for it. I'm not having a very good feel. How long have you been working on this piece?
Then about 5 weeks.
Oh well. It'll be great when it's in the exhibition.
Yeah.
What kind of things do you paint? Do you prefer painting or pottery? Yeah. What's harder? Which one's harder, painting or pottery?
Painting.
Harder? Yeah. They're all going to go in the...
Yeah, but they could spill out of it, couldn't they, if they're all fitting. Yeah. You know, be something on a plinth, and they could come out from it.
Just how you want it set up and stuff? Yeah.
Okay.
If that's okay.
Make a chimney. You wish you could.
I see that. Yeah? How long did that take?
Both!
Wait! Oh, is that all? Is that still on? Yeah. Oh, it's all right.
Yes.
That's all right.
What can we do? They can
Yeah, I think that's fine. Couple of holes. Adds a bit of character.
And there's a bit of...
That's alright.
Well, they do two
sets,
but this
five
are doing
it.
I think it's nice.
Do
you like it?
I love it.
Love it? Oh, that's the most important thing. As long as you like it.
But people buy it.
Why not?
If they go off.
Because it's just part of, like, it doesn't matter.
Oh, is
this all your stuff from here then?
Yeah. Yeah, they do come out so good.
I like this one.
Yeah.
Slightly, then we want to go faster.
Okay. Is the speed important?
Sorry?
Is the speed important?
Yeah, right. Yeah. It tells you when you're not quite there. The faster it goes, the more like the vibration in your hand is. If you go really slow, you don't get that vibration. But when you go flat out, it just tells you. Because if it's not in the centre, you, that one's quite fairly round because it was in the centre.
Do you find it relaxing then?
I love it, yeah.
I think I quite
interested. I can almost do it blindfolded, and shut my eyes and just do it. So, because I'm not under pressure to make a pot, do you understand what I mean? If I was, say I was working in pottery and I had to do 100 an hour, then I'd be under pressure. But when it's only, it's just you and the clay and it's spinning, and it's especially the turning, the next stage when you're tidying up the pot, it's... Yeah, I suppose it's because you're not worried if most of the pots don't survive anyway. And I've never what I'd call done one perfectly. You know what I mean? I'm still aiming for the perfect. That's centering knife. I was trying to throw goblets before, and quite thin stemmed, about this high, so you've got the bowl. So you're going to start pushing downwards. But push with one hand locked into the hands. That's it. It's getting the hands comfortable. It's the tricky bit. That's it. Yeah, okay. Sorry?
Did you teach yourself how to
do it? Well, I did it 1969, 1970 when I was at school.
Yeah.
Then there's a big gap. But a couple of years ago I came in here with, you know, and... But Trish only drags me in to teach. She doesn't let me actually do it. No, I'm happy to show people. Because you learn anyway. But it's one of those things, to get your hands in the right position, it just comes. It has to come naturally. You can't, if you're not doing it. Because what you're doing, you're stopping it moving out with a strong left hand, and your thumb's holding
pushing against it.
Yeah.
But your other thumb, it's almost like playing a musical instrument. You know, your other thumb automatically drops on the top of the pot. It just does it. And then the other one will curl round. So you're pushing against that part of the hand, so it really makes it strong. Whereas if a lot of people sort of push over there or the tips of the fingers, but when you've got the clay that's spinning around in between that thumb, which that locks on there, it can't go anywhere, so you draw it out. It has to go out gently.
Practice is crucial.
Yeah, but my hands do it automatically. That's the thing. It's very hard to teach that part of it. I just go straight on there and I lock my hands in and just do it. So it's the Gavin's hands improving. But if one hand isn't working with the other, then you get the wobble. The wobbly bit comes back again because you push it out too quickly.
Do you say it's like learning instruments?
It is. Well, because you're using all your fingers and and your thumb. Your thumb automatically taps down on it to stop it coming up. No, completely useless. I don't know why, but my whole family are musical apart from me. My brother plays the violin, and my younger brother plays the piano, and my mum used to play the accordion, and you know, we're all sort of. But I'm guessing it's because I'm a bit tone deaf, really. I can't really. I spent a year trying to tune a guitar in, I could never get it just right.
Very difficult.
Whereas my girlfriend at the time, she picked the guitar up, she learnt in half an hour, and then 2 hours later she's performing, doing a bit of Simon and Garfunkel. But now it either comes easily, or but can you see how easily my hands go into this? They just go straight in, and then they're working. There's a lot going on in there that you don't actually see, but they're working each other. Oh, that's feeling good. What I really need, though, is someone who's very, very good at pottery to give me that next. Because there's lots of shortcuts or lots of ways of improving pottery, which I will eventually pick up. But when I only do 2 hours every week, it's not enough by any means. I need a lot more time. And I'd eventually work it out, but it's much easier if someone shows you.
Of course, yeah.
When he had a wobbly rim, the other chap who showed me instantly had it. Get the room sorted out. So
I've only got London.
Whereas it may have taken me months to work that out, how easily it
ruined it.
In what way? Oh, have you gone in there?
Gently curl it again. Because
we're making a museum underneath. But I do tourist information, that's my. Which I quite like. We get all sorts, get the whole world coming in. You get Brazilians and French and Italian and Dutch. Most of them speak pretty good English. Well, they put us to shame on that. Especially the Scandinavians, you don't even pick up the accent.
Really?
Yeah, beautiful. But I quite enjoy that, because I can give them the full half an hour on history of folk if they want. Quite happy to go on about that for a
while. Have you always been in Folkestone then?
No, 70s I moved here, but with collaboration with a lady, I wrote a book on the history of Oakston. We did a chronology, so...
What's it called?
Just called The Chronology of Oakston. When did we do that? About 2004. I did sort of 1800s of the present day, and I went through every local newspaper in the upstairs in the heritage room for 200 years worth. A lot of it is brief stuff, so if you want to know what happened in 1911, it'll give you where to look in detail, or if it'll tell you the main events, but not in full depth, but it'll tell you where to find the full details. A good example is 1917, where the bomb landed in Tontine Street. I don't know if you heard of that. Yeah, it was one of the... They basically were trying to bomb London. It was a sort of scare tactics for London, but the bad weather turned them round at Chatham, followed the railway load down through Ashford, dropped a couple of bombs at Shorncliffe, one bomb left, landed just up the road there and killed 60 people. They were queuing up for potatoes, mainly, and veg and things. I'm working on some collages at the moment, but I'm not sure they'll be there. I just got so many pictures of sort of 60 stuff, and I just love putting them together, and it's just happening. And they really buzz. They really. I'm pleased with that.
Do you find art as a whole relaxing?
Yeah. I love painting. Yeah. I think it's almost like a bit like sort of when you meditate or go really relaxed. Yeah, you can lose hours doing it and just feel really I mean, the only way I can really explain it, which is a good way of saying it, is about a year ago, and I was in town doing some painting, and got on the bus. I couldn't remember where I lived, the name of the road. I knew I was going nowhere. I just said, I want to go home. I had to get off the bus because I couldn't tell the driver where I was going. Because my brain was so focused on the other thing. You know, obviously I said, you know, I want to go home. Which is not helpful to a bus driver, he wants to give you a ticket. But that I couldn't think of the name of my road. I was too switched into what the other thing I was doing. And, but that shows, you know, that's not because it's not because I've got Alzheimer's, it's the opposite. And I'm so focused in what I've been doing. But,
once you start on something, do you really focus on it then?
Yeah, I can do, but I also I can go back to things as well. I might get bored after a few weeks and then I'll leave it and come back to it. But I found a drawing, I'd stepped into one, which I did around about 1980, roughly. But I've got no memory of doing it. I don't know what it means, and it's quite weird, because normally I understand. If I can't interpret it, then nobody can. So it's quite weird.
All stuff means something.
Yeah, all very much. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff going on that way. Yeah. So yeah, I mean, normally it reflects what's happening around you. You know, something like I might sneak into my Belgian refugee thing, something to do with the.
Yeah. For a second.
I mean, the thing I'm thinking about at the moment, obviously, is our referendum in next month, because I've no idea how to vote on that one. I can't.
No. So do your surroundings quite affect
them
with the work?
Yeah, very much so, yeah. But, I mean, sometimes I'm stuck in the 60s, so I'm always thinking about that as well, Hendrix-y stuff. Anniversary of Noel Redding tomorrow, 11th of May. He died 2003, but I'm guessing one of the really interesting things about Facebook and other certain sites, you can, if you've got an interest, like my things are like Stonehenge, but also Hendrix and other things like that, you can talk to people in Australia, Canada, and you know, share ideas, and it's not hard. Even I can do it. I'm not a technology person at all, but if I can do it, then I think anyone can, but that is nice.
The 60s was a big, quite a
good
move for you
then. Yeah, it was when I was 16 in 1969, I think that really made all the difference. You just at the, when everything's coming around you, girls, music, fashion, you know, everything like that is, I loved the artwork, posters, pop art, and people like Andy Warhol, you know, they were just such a big influence. And
Did you really
influence you? Yeah. I mean, my mum was at art college then. She sort of, the parents split up, and my mum went back to art college and then became an art teacher. So that was at the same time that we were both doing A-level art at the same time, which was quite nice. I mean, she was doing that as well. I've got an uncle who's dead now, unfortunately, but he was quite a famous sculptor, so there is connections, yeah.
Oh, so it's in your fingers.
It's though. There, isn't it? Yeah, Robert Thomas. Yeah, Bob Thomas. He did busts of Princess Di and people like that in the 80s. Yeah. Most of his work is in Swansea, Dylan Thomas stuff. The characters from Dylan Thomas, things like that.
Undermilk Wood.
Yeah, and Captain Cat or something. I'm not really a Dylan Thomas person, but I love the voices. I like. But yeah. So I guess it runs in your bones somewhere.
Do you enjoy teaching?
Yeah. I quite like recently at ARC. I did a 5-minute painting, so I had some thoughts in my hands. So blank canvas. They filmed me and just did it in 5 minutes. It is somewhere on ARC's.
Oh, I saw
it. It's a sort of ghosty face that appears. If you've seen that one, yeah, that sort of thing. I quite like. I quite like an audience.
Yeah.
What did you do after school? I didn't do A-level. I did A-level art.
Yeah.
We did learn physics and
Yeah. No one ever taught me, that's why I can't do it.
Just draw anything. Sometimes you just go and draw what you see.
Yeah.
You just look and put down what you see. There are a few rules, I suppose. I can't do perspective.
Yeah, I'm not even going to have a full
round. Oh, really?
I better be on the
pole,
I'm there.
Yeah.
It's quite crazy.
I don't usually use a lot of perspective. Yeah. I mean, I'd be, if I got some time, I don't really want to make things look like photographs, like real. I don't want to do that. I don't know what I want, really. I like the teeth of the cafe. They're my favourite paintings.
I can see a bit of it there.
Yeah, they're my favourite paintings.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He would, Castle would have been 100 years old. I sort of read somewhere that it would have been his birthday, like a week ago or something.
Oh, really? Would have been 100?
100, I think, yeah.
Oh, right. Yeah, just go with that long ago, didn't
Not really,
you?
No.
We went to his exhibition the other week, we kept in the National Gallery.
Yeah.
Did you see it?
I did see it, yeah, it was really good.
Yeah. Oh, I love his.
I do something different. Yeah.
Oh, no, do you like colours? Yeah, they're fantastic.
It's a strange feeling.
Oh, they're so simple. Yeah. They're so effective around the world, aren't they? Powerful.
Do we need more papers? Alright, I'll take your word for it.
But I do think art's overpriced.
Unless I'm away. If I was going to go to my dad's, I'll tell you.
So, yeah, the exhibition will be really good. 2 whole weeks. Yeah, it's a good amount of time.
You have got a lot of space.
Loads of space, yeah. Are you worried your pictures won't fit?
Well, I've got to say,
it'll be fine.
Right.
Yeah, fantastic. Whatever you want, we'll do.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you know what you're putting in the show already?
More or less, yeah. I'm putting another face in. I did the other week.
Thank you.
I might put this one in. It looks a bit deranged. I might put that one in. There's a seascape. I did.
No,
I watched
that basically on the belly. Trying to play. And then we had to go back.
Is that all right? Yeah.
Now, when I was...
Is a black background there now?
Well, when I was starting to paint again, I was with this tutor in Ashwood, Starwood, and she always used to paint my canvases black.
That's interesting.
And I thought, yeah, I like that. I tell you what, Mark, I cannot work from a white background. I can't draw on a white.
What's that?
I don't know. I just.
Yeah.
But you give me a black like black, and give me some oil, coloured oils, or pastels or whatever, and I love. You can see what's coming out when in colours. I'm lost with the white and a pencil.
Because most artists, like, so I go and visit artists like yourself and like artists and stuff.
Yeah.
And most of them will paint on white. So I think it's interesting you choose black.
Well, maybe it could also be to do with the brain injury I suffered. And but I love. So when I was working with this tutor in Ashford, and she painted my canvas black. We started playing around. I thought, yeah, it's right, it feels right, because it's like that now, like that canvas there with colours I can do. It's like I love working pastels. It's there and you've got the colour, and you know, you can see what colour you've got. I can't do that with it onto white. I don't know, it's weird, I just don't like doing it on white.
It obviously works for you, because your pictures are amazing.
Yeah, because it's like, I'm not looking at that. So I use lovely colours. No, that's right, yeah. That's that geezer. Fly geezer in Nevada. But that is what I love about the internet. Since the internet, before you had the internet, come. But now, since I was at camera in the internet, and you get all sorts of different images just come up on the screen. You know that one. And then you just go and get a copy of it or whatever. And there must be about 50 and 100 paintings.
Fantastic. Are you really close with your dad then?
Yes. More so now than what I used to be, obviously, because since my soul, because I do get on well with my dad. We do get on well. I mean, it's like I get on well with all my family. It's not one of my family I don't like. I've got on well with all of my family. And especially after what happened to me in 87, because I was a big man and I almost got wiped out one night and no one could believe it. And so they stopped, they nursed me through because they saw what I was going through. But it took a long time before I even came around to realising and talking to him. And that was so bizarre. But they were always helping me. And while I got better, and then as I am now, I still rely on them for help, for lifts and everything. I only live.
I rely on my dad for lifts. You used to play football?
Oh, I used to love him, yeah. I did. I used to play for Ashford Borough, and I also played for Aldington. And then when I was a kid growing up, I used to play for South Ashford Youth Club at the time. And I used to play Ornington Men's on Sundays.
Right. Did you think then you'd be a painter now?
Sorry?
Did you think then you'd be a painter now?
No. Well, no, because obviously I was able-bodied and disability thoughts never written in months. I just never thought of them disabled. And that is a bizarre thing. I went out to a local pub one night, and I had a girlfriend who lived in Ham Street, and I was always going down to see her. And that one specific night, she said she wasn't going to be around. She had gone out somewhere, so I went after her, so I wouldn't bother coming down. But then, on that night, I was having trouble with my car. So my car broke down, so I couldn't go down there anyway. So I'll stay at home this night. I'll go to the local pub. And I was in the local pub that night. When it all kicked off in there. And I was in the middle of it. I took a bad beating. I was in a coma for 5 months. So we wouldn't expect to live. But that's what I couldn't really, when I come out of the coma. I never thought I would do art again. But life is, in the early instances after my assault, I didn't know how it was going to go on, but over the years I've managed to keep a normal head, so to speak. But then I do like a lot of dance tunes, because when I was able-bodied, I was always at clubbing. I used to love dance music.
You're a good dancer?
Yeah. Oh, I used to be, yeah. I was always out dancing. And I would now, if I could. But I was just no good at 360s. couldn't spin. My sense of balance is dreadful.
But you could dance, though?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I've got good rhythm. Good rhythm, and
does that help you paint? The rhythm?
I believe so. I think because within myself as a person or individual, I know I keep a beat. Oh, good. When I was a kid, me and my sister used to go off riding. My brother, he's 4 years older than me, he never ever wanted to know.
Really?
Didn't want. But I do know now. He's been riding since.
Oh, has he?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I'd love to try it, but, like, you know.
Do it. I'm not going to do it.
Yeah.
Give it a go. It's got to be worth a try.
I'm not sure if I'm too old for it now.
No one's too old. Too old? How old are you younger than me?
22.
Yeah, Miles, you are the age I was at when I got assaulted. Yeah, I was 22 when I was assaulted. So you're not too old. And I was always riding with them prior to that.
Yeah.
When I was a kid. And I've been ridden since. And the thing that stopped me riding was I went back to art college. I'm still in that. But we just have a lot more points than what's in there now.
Are you using pastels today then?
Yeah. I love working pastels. You can smudge it about.
What is it you like about the pastel texture?
Well, what is it about pastels? Is that pastel, I think, like, you can just go on it. What I love about pastel is the fact that I can smudge, move the media. That's what I like about pastels. You can move stuff about.
There's a lot of movement in all your pictures, I've noticed.
Yeah.
Is that like a theme you like to work with then?
Yeah, that's not, that's how I used to work. When I was with this tutor, Trudy Barber, she taught me when I was at a social house, and it was her, she advised me to go abstract. And then I just want to go mad and get. I didn't know, but I knew what I was doing.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean. I didn't know what I was doing, but I knew what I was doing. And I just love creating things. Did some paintings. I used to paint on the floor.
It's
just put a big canvas on the floor, and it's got my hands and knees, and just crawl around. All saying that, when I was in the wheelchair, I had on one of those sticks, I had a paintbrush, or paintbrushes attached to my walking stick. I used to paint with a big stick because I adopted that idea from when I was studying abstract art, Jackson Pollock.
I love Pollock.
Yeah. I actually did do some painting with a stick.
Yeah.
I even attached paintbrushes to my stick, and I was painting from distance. I still love doing it because everything was a chance, but everything was different, and I just loved it. It's had a barber named Harbour, and then I can't remember.
Yeah,
yeah,
nice. Like,
yeah, yeah, that's what. Well, Steve. It's Stephen.
Miles.
Sorry, Steve. Sorry, Miles. Now. So what's his name?
Corley.
How's that, Miles?
See, you want
to,
I'll take you a card.
Yeah. Yeah, that'd be better, right?
There you go.
Go ahead. Thank you. Now, Miles, I asked one now. Where did you get these cards printed?